I want to say a big thank you to all of the Patreon supporters, and also a big thank you to those of you who are a member on this channel. More information in the description box. So, where are my glasses? So a lot of you have been noticing about the hair. In the last video, a lot of you were talking about my hair and how I suit long. Thank you, I'm growing it. I was going for a Captain America thing, but I think it's gonna be more of a Sam Winchester thing. It used to be really wavy when I was younger, when I had longer hair when I was in school. It was quite wavy, and this is very straight for some reason. Don't know why. Anyway, this is about just doing it. This video is aimed at anyone who's trying to accomplish something, be that writing a book or starting a YouTube channel or anything that requires you to actually achieve something, you to actually put in the time and effort into making something. That could be a video as well. See, I try and find my glasses and I just take them off straight away. We occasionally get ideas for concepts and things, like, as I said earlier, story. Maybe you want to make a YouTube channel or a YouTube video. Maybe you have a business model idea, or maybe there's a routine that you want to try and adopt. There's loads of different things that you can try to do, and you can plan to do them as well. So you want to do it, you want to make it, you want to build it, you want to sell it. Either way, you need a plan, and then you need to execute the plan. I love planning things. If I have a spreadsheet involved with anything, then I'm a happy bunny. However, there comes a time where it doesn't matter how much you plan on doing something. If you don't actually start doing the thing that you're planning, it just accounts for nothing, because planning something and doing them are two separate things. Planning is not doing, and doing isn't a plan. You could be the best planner in the world. You could write a meticulously thought out plan. You can get a spreadsheet. You can get times and dates and people and email addresses and things like that. But if you don't actually just go out and do the plan, then it doesn't matter how well your plan is. If you've got a perfect plan, but you never execute any of that plan, and then this plan doesn't matter. It's always best to have a half-baked idea and execute it half as well than having a perfect plan and never doing anything about it. So without getting all Shia LaBeouf on you, you need to just do it. Even with this video, I was downstairs in the kitchen and I was thinking about all the different things that I could do in order to achieve doing this video. How many things I've got to do today, how many things I've got to do in the week, and how am I going to fit all of it and do everything. And then I thought, I'm just wasting time thinking about the ideas that I want to do, and instead I could just be upstairs right now and just film, which is what I'm doing now. I'll give you a greater example. Writing a book, writing a novel. Let's say you're writing a fantasy book, and you can outline the idea of your fantasy book. You can create a world, you can create a magic system, a political system, create characters with family trees and intense backgrounds behind those characters. You can create unique concepts and plot points and magical artifacts. All of it. You can plan the whole book down to every minute detail. Unless you start writing down words in your actual book, then it means nothing. I myself struggle with this idea of planning versus doing. I always plan meticulously and I never execute those plans. The amount of times I've had Google documents or Google spreadsheets in my Google Drive that are all for different plans that I've had in the past, but I've never actually gone and done those plans, you would be surprised how often that occurs. And that's kind of one of the reasons why I decided to do daily videos. Do you know what? I'm going to open this curtain. And that's kind of why I decided to do daily videos again, because it's the best way to be able to plan, but you still have to do. You have a time, you have a limit on what you can do and when you have to do it by. So for example, with this channel, I had loads of ideas of things that I wanted to do with it. I had upload schedules already written down. I had a few ideas for the videos. I had themes of the channel, and I had the other channel as well, which I was writing about themes for as well. I had lots of ideas, but no execution of those ideas at all. So my advice to anyone who's watching this and thinking about something that they want to do, the biggest bit of advice that I can give you is to stop planning. Obviously, get an outline, but plan is very little to do with what you need to do. Unless, of course, it's like a corporate event or something similar. you need to execute more than anything. I'm gonna make a video in the future about how to start a channel, how to outline ideas, make a content plan and all that, so that you have an understanding about how to start in the YouTube world. The best advice in regards to approach to doing something is not to get something that is too large for you to digest. If you bite off more than you can chew, then you just cannot digest it. And you see this all the time when it comes to New Year's resolutions. You see this all the time when it comes to goals, fitness goals, diets. If people bite off more than they can chew, generally speaking, they're not going to achieve it. Because after a while, it's a psychological thing in which your brain just says, no, I cannot do this. I'm just going to flat out not do it. So do one thing, change one thing. If you're starting a new diet, or you're changing your diet rather, then you just need to do one thing that's different from your diet previously. So for example, if you are like me and you consume a lot of sugar, the best idea is not to cut out sugar completely. The best idea is to stop one thing at a time. With me, it's fizzy drinks. If I stop drinking fizzy drinks and it progresses and after about a month I've stopped drinking fizzy drinks completely, then you can add something else. Build it up slowly so that you can do something. And that goes to doing things like writing a book. If you're writing a book, don't try and like, I'm gonna get a chapter done a week. You know, don't think about that. Just write 400 words. It's not a lot, but if it's too much, cut that down to 200. If 400's not enough, then push that up to 600. Don't bite off more than you can chew. Set your levels low. Set your levels low and build from there. Don't start high and drop down, because that also has a psychological effect on you, in which you start and it's like, yeah, I can do this. And then when you realize that you can't do it, oh, I feel awful because I can't do it. So when you have an idea of something that you want to do and you started executing it the way that you have thought fit, say for example, writing 400 words a day, then if you continuously do that for 2 months, then that is a habit. And that habit becomes something a part of your routine, which means it's autonomous, which means you don't even need to think about it. It's because it's something that you do, kind of like cleaning your teeth or wiping your bum. It's something that you're doing, not something you've got to think about doing. To prove my point, I'm going to do something that I've wanted to do for the longest time ever, and that is start a Casey Neistat routine. Now, Casey Neistat, as you all are aware, is a powerhouse when it comes to productivity. He does things because he does them. He doesn't plan them meticulously, he just does them. But part of the reason that he does all of the work that he does in a day is because he has this really, really insane routine in which he gets up at between 4 and 5 in the morning, he does some work, he does this, he does that, and he just keeps on going, and he just keeps on doing, and every time he does something, it means that he can do something else, and his productivity levels are so high that it's something to be in awe of, really, to be honest. So I'm gonna try and start a Casey Neistat. I'm gonna start trying to do something similar on the lines of Casey Neistat. I'm thinking about getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning. If I just do that, if I just do it and not think about it, then I'll be happy. 5 o'clock in the morning, each morning. Each morning I get up a little. I'm very interested to see what you guys want to achieve. So in the comments section below, I want you to do two things. I want you to write down the thing that you want to do. Say for example, it is writing a book. And I also want you to write down alongside with that, the thing that you're going to do in order to achieve that. The thing that you're going to do day in, day out, that will help you achieve the goal that you've set for yourself. So for me, I think the first thing I need to do is to wake up early in the morning. So thank you very much. If you want to be a member or a Patreon supporter, then links are in the description box below. Take a look at all the videos I've got on the channel, and at the end, there will be a card somewhere to the video I did before this. So until then, bye. Each morning I get up, I cry a little. Yeah, I'm barely standing on my feet. Take a look in the mirror and cry.